most of the time, it is I who yearn, it is I who live for myself, and everybody should follow me. That kind of nature destroys not only the families, it also stops the divine grace and the spirit to flow into us. No clouds take bath in its own rain. No tree eats its own fruits, but still they bear fruits. But still the clouds give their water. And you and I carry life, even if you receive it or not. Only in giving you receive. Only in dying you live. Only in forgiving you are being forgiven. So if God tells Manava's wife, if you want, it is not possible by you. So Manava's wife says, wait, wait, I will go and call my husband. The angel says, yes, that is the way. Go until you come. Then she says, the wife says, but if you disappear, the angel says, no. You don't know the ways of God. If you go and bring your husband, that is the time you will see me fully. So as an individual, the wife, she only saw the vision of the angel. But when the husband came, the revelation of what God is going to do through them is revealed. Most of the time when you pray alone, maybe you may get a nice vision. When I was praying, I saw some shaking, some breeze came, some light came. Hallelujah, I saw the vision. Waste. Unless you receive the revelation, all that you see, all that external things, maybe we, when children love, we give chocolates, but chocolates are not the food for the growth. Food is food, chocolate is chocolate. Don't get satisfied with a little experience. I had this dream, I had that vision, I had... No, go beyond. And to go beyond, you need to move with the people whom God has given to you. If you cannot move and love those whom God has given to you, how do you expect God to move with you and to love you? So immediately the wife and husband, they came together, and the husband brings the food and they put it on the rock, and they say, Lord, if you really accept us, please accept the food. Sometime, though God comes down from heaven to the earth, still the man on this earth doesn't believe the God of heaven. He wants always assurance. Please, will you accept my food? Arre, God has come to be with you. But still, Manava and his wife, they are not satisfied. Will you accept what I give you? God says, okay. So the angel stood with them when they did not stand with God. Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord. The third thing the Lord said to Manava and his wife, take care of your hair that comes from your head. The hair is the symbol of your dedication to God. So take care of the hair that I am giving to your son Samson. Tell him to take care of it. Christ, as we read in the book of Colossians, chapter 2, verse 10. Christ, as we read from 1 chapter, verse 9 onwards, Christ is the head. We read in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9, that we are built on him, that we may be built with him. We are called not only to build on Christ, but also to build our lives with Christ. Many people, many Christians build their lives on Christ through their baptism. But that is not the guarantee for God to move with us. You have to move with God. So Christian life has to bear fruit. It has to be built not only on God, but also with God. You have to consult him. You have to talk to him. You have to know him. You have to move your life according to him. That is meaning that we have to build our Christian life not only on God, but also with God. Praise the Lord. Are you with me? Or am I talking somewhere else? Are you? Okay. Praise the Lord. So the hair comes from the head. From Christ comes the Holy Spirit. If the Holy Spirit has to move from you, you have to take care of your hair. You have to take care of your head. So if the Holy Spirit has to come out of you to fill you with the Spirit of, you have to take care of your relationship with Christ. Your relationship with your Christ. Without building up your relationship with Christ, without reading the Word of God, sometime even that is terribly misunderstood by a lot of Christians. They think by reading the Word of God, I will receive the anointing. No. Word of God, of course, there will be another talk for you. The Word of God helps us to hear the voice of God. So the Word of God, now I want to go somewhere else. So, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Can I go, Lord? Can I go? Go. Go and commit suicide. Will you go? It is not, Bible is not a magic book. No. When you read the Word of God for a particular situation in which you are living, you will hear the voice of God. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd, and my sheep will listen to my voice, and they will obey my voice. Listening is different, obeying is different. Of course, I don't want to go into that topic. So, if you want to see God in you, God never said, whatever may be your problem, you come to me, I will follow you. God never said. The Lord said, come and follow me. So we have to follow Him. We have to follow His voice. We have to listen to His voice. So when we move in love of Christ, when we read the Word of God, when we worship the Lord, we begin to hear the voice of God. We read in the book of Matthew, chapter 3, verse 17 onwards. After receiving the baptism, Jesus came out and He started to pray. Many people misunderstand that baptism is the starting point of life. You receive baptism with the water up or drowned, that doesn't help you. Wherever, what kind of glass in which you drink coffee, whether it is a cup of coffee or a glass of coffee, that doesn't matter. Whether you are, no, you have to be drowned, then only you will go to heaven. These are people who do not know the truth. So it is not during the baptism Jesus received revelation. You read the Bible clearly. Jesus, after the baptism, your baptism, if it has to bear fruit, your baptism has to be in union with voice of God. Through prayer, Jesus was in touch with the voice of God. And hearing the voice of God leads you to obey the voice of God. So the Bible says, after the baptism, Jesus went out and prayed. The first thing for the receiving of the Holy Spirit, after the baptism, acknowledging that I belong to Jesus, from now on I will live a life of Jesus, which becomes the base to become a Christian. And then he started to pray. When he prayed, the Bible says the heaven got open. When did the heaven get open? When he was praying alone. When he prayed, heaven. So your prayer, really, if it is that you have prayed, means the heaven should get open for you. If the heaven is not getting opened for you, your prayer is prevented by something else. You have to find out. So prayer basically leads, you want to read it? Please read fast. Okay. Read. Because I see the sister reading. Can you read fast? Jesus, after the baptism, he came out and started to pray. And three things happened. Number one, the heaven got opened. The second thing, he heard the voice of God from heaven. Who Jesus is. The third is the identity of Jesus. Who is Jesus? Why has God sent him into the world? The mission of yours. So prayer basically brings three things to you. Check your prayer life. Are you really praying? Whatever may be type of prayer. See to it that your prayer, does it bear fruit? That when Jesus prayed, number one, heaven got opened. Number two, he heard the voice of God. You are my beloved son. And third, in you I am well pleased. Go on, move on with the life you are begun. Go ahead. The enemy is coming to attack you. I am with you. Go. With the power of my spirit, fight against the evil spirit and prove to the world that the one who is in you is stronger, greater, sufficient than the forces in the world. So the fourth is, you are sent through prayer, you are empowered to dispower, to disempower the evil spirit, to remove the power of the enemy. So your prayer is empowered. You are given the sword to cut the head of the enemy.